In this presentation, I shall discuss a few important aspects of concerning the magnetic field evolution in the polar regions of the Sun and their implications for the solar cycle. The background image here shows a comparison of the predicted magnetic field configuration of the Sun to the observed Lasco-C2 image for the December 2019 solar eclipse performed at Arc Group using a combination of data-driven surface flux transport model and a potential field source surface model. This indicates how the large-scale distribution of the surface fields governs the overall structuring and dynamics of the Sun's outer atmosphere. Although I shall not focus on this aspect, it is important to note that better constraints on high latitude field distribution would also constrain high latitude corona as well. Mainly, I'll focus on three important components of the polar field evolution. The first concerns the polar flux cancellation and buildup dynamics that leads to generation of large scale polar field. Second, I shall discuss the importance of constraining one of the flux transport processes, namely meridional circulation, which is believed to play an important role in baculitin dynamo mechanism. Third, I shall discuss the intriguing observation of Kilgauss magnetic patches near the Sun's poles by Hinode and the importance of exploring their origin and contributions to the solar dynamo. The polar magnetic field is a proxy of the global internal polar del field. While the large-scale magnetic field distribution and its strength acts as seed for the following solar cycle, the localized field configuration plays an important role in driving polar plumes, jets, and shaping the fast solar wind, which are key modulators of the space weather. The left panel here shows a result of 3D kinematic dynamo simulation based on Baker-Clayton approach. The dynamics of the polar field buildup and reversal depend on tilted bipolar magnetic active regions and their subsequent flux dispersal by near surface processes such as diffusion, differential rotation, and meridional circulation. These processes play a fundamental role in determining the polar field and the amplitude of the next sunspot cycle. Given the fact that the polar field observations from the ecliptic plane are compromised due to projection effects, MST simulations that I'll highlight and observations from solar orbiter and other out of the ecliptic missions may return important new insights on the solar activity. The tilt angle, flux, and emergence latitudes of the solar active regions visualized in the solar butterfly diagram in the bottom panel and the surface flux transport processes result in the cancellation and buildup of the polar field, which is depicted in the middle panel and is seen to lag the sunspot cycle shown in the top panel with a 90 degree phase difference. The polar del field, of which the polar field is a surface manifestation, is then transported into the solar convection zone where the toroidal component of the subsequent solar cycle is produced. The correlation between the polar field of cycle N and the amplitude of cycle N plus 1 is very well known. This implies that the dynamics leading to the polar field buildup bridges the ongoing cycle to the following cycle. Understanding this buildup process through high latitude observations is critical to understanding the progression of the solar cycle. Accurate constraints on the polar field strength and the total flux content in the polar cap during a cycle minima is also critical to accurate predictions of the solar cycle, as indicated in this century scale simulation and prediction of solar activity by Vomick and Nangi 2018. In this plot, the top panel shows the variation of the average polar flux. In order to focus on the dynamics of the polar field, I chose to plot a section of the whole time series. In the bottom, the co-temporal sunspot time series is plotted. The filled red circles indicate the solar maxima and the blue ones denote the minimum. And the polar flux grows in a phase where the toroidal flux of the solar cycle is declining. The polar field growth rate, which can be calculated by looking at the polar flux at the solar cycle maximum and the minimum. This growth rate can be related to the amplitude of the sunspot cycle, which tells us that what is the role of the flux emergence during a particular cycle in governing the growth rate. A preliminary, somewhat naive analysis relating just the emergent active region flux of a cycle to the polar field growth rate that already hints at the existence of relationship through this calculated relation of 0.71. This growth rate of the polar field is governed by the rate at which flux cancellation and the subsequent flux buildup proceeds at the poles. This is governed by the polytail field source in the dynamo mechanism, which does involve the flux emergence profile and mid to high latitude flux transport, which is currently unconstrained through observations and is studied only using flux transport models. The solar surface flux transport process carries the flux from low latitudes to the poles via large scale transport processes, that is differential rotation, meridional circulation and supergranular diffusion. The differential rotation component is well constrained from observations, but the meridional flow profile, which such models indicate is responsible for carrying the net flux to the polar regions, remains unconstrained at high latitudes. Constraints on the speed of the meridional flow and the latitudinal extent to which it reaches to the poles are outstanding questions. Answers to these would help us figure out the extent of the polar cap that is built up at the minimum of a cycle and how flux cancellation proceeds at the boundary of this polar cap. Commonly used meridional flow profiles utilize a flow speed of maximum amplitude around 10 to 15 meters per second. Typically, this flow is limited to 75 degrees latitude. So we used surface flux transport simulations with CESFT model to illustrate how different meridional flow profiles reaching to different latitudinal extents near the poles play a crucial role in determining the polar cap extent. For that, we prescribed two different flow profiles extending until 85 degrees, which is shown in the blue profile, and till 70 degrees, which is the magenta profile in the model, to see their impact on the boundary of the polar cap. For the flow profile which extends closer to the poles, the simulation indicates the polar cap is limited closer to the poles. In the butterfly diagram, the solid green lines denote the cap boundaries as the flow profile extends until 85 degrees. We notice a contraction in the polar cap boundaries in the left panel. The meridional flow profile can be constrained from the magnetic feature tracking and helioseismic observations from out of the ecliptic missions. The polar cap extent can be constrained by high latitude magnetogram observations. Our proof of concept simulation illustrates how important these observations would be in exploring the dynamics of the polar cap and its interplay at high latitude flux transport processes. Moving on to the final portion of my discussion, here is a curious case of the observed Kilo-Gauss polar patches. Although the observations of polar field is very difficult with ongoing missions, on several occasions Hinode mission was able to record the solar poles. The right panel shows one such observation extending from 85 degrees to 70 degrees near the South Pole, which reveals the presence of concentrated magnetic patches with amplitude of the order of Kilo-Gauss, which have a lifetime of several hours to one day. On the left, we plot the observations from the HMI instrument, which is not so good near the poles, where the polar cap is clearly not visible because there are projection effects near the poles. But these unique Kilo-Gauss unipolar patches cannot be observed in current missions, which are most likely to be observed in upcoming missions, which are looking at the sun from the out of the ecliptic plane. So what is the origin of these intriguing Kilo-Gauss polar patches? What role do these Kilo-Gauss patches play in the overall dynamics of the polar field and the solar dynamo mechanism? They are still open questions as of now. So to understand the flux transport close to the polar caps, one should ideally focus near the polar region. Here our SFT simulations shows the evolution of the solar surface for 1 month using one of the HMI observed Carrington maps as input. The contours here denote the patches of magnitude plus or minus 5 Gauss, It is apparent that the polar cap contains non-uniformities, which the contour is highlighting. The regions are relatively high in magnetic field amplitude, but clearly in this simple kinematic simulations, one does not see strong Kilgauss patches, and this indicates the necessity of building in the physics of turbulent convection or some other mechanism near the polar regions for creation of these localized Kilgauss patches. We aim to perform such simulations to understand the origin and dynamics of these polar patches. Observations of the high latitude polar regions that constrain the properties of these high field patches and the scale and the lifetime of the surface convection and the flow in this region can critically inform our models and reveal the physics of these curious Kilgauss regions. Accurate measurement of the flux content of these strong field regions would also provide more accurate constraints on the polar cap flux, and thus they might lead to more accurate prediction of the following sunspot cycle. To summarize, the amount of flux that emerges during the cycle plays a role in determining the dynamics that governs the polar field growth rate. This growth rate of the polar field will only be affected because of the transport of flux from the low latitudes to the polar regions. Therefore, one of the important roles that upcoming polar field missions can play is to explore these dynamics of high latitude flux transport leading to flux cancellation and build up of the polar cap. The extent of the polar cap and its overall flux content at solar minima depends critically on the nature of the meridional flow, as proven by these simulations that we showed here. However, the profile of the meridional flow remains unconstrained at high latitudes. So high latitude observations using helioseismic methods or magnetic feature tracking methods from out of the ecliptic missions will definitely give us some more insight, and they really have the potential to reveal the high latitude flows and the interplay of these flows and the magnetic field that create, sustain and destroy the polar cap. Lastly, the non-uniformity in field distribution near the sun's polar regions, especially the curious Kilgauss patches, may play important roles in the formation of polar plumes and jets which drive high-speed solar winds. So they may also be a new and unexplored element in the context of the solar cycle. Their origin is still unknown. So it's important to see how they are formed and what is the dynamics of such patches near the poles. So these are uncharted territories and outstanding questions. We anticipate that a combination of numerical simulations and out of the ecliptic observations of the sun's poles would help us explore these uncharted territories, leading to fundamental new insights about solar activity from its interior to its outer atmosphere. I'd like to thank and acknowledge that the Center of Excellence in Space Sciences India is funded by Ministry of Education and the Government of India under the Frontier Areas of Science and Technology Scheme. Thank you.